Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I made another travel journal kit. It's number 14. I can't believe it, but yes, it's true. And it's the first fall themed one or journal this year. And as you can see, there's this beautiful image on the front, and I dyed some fabric with coffee and water, get this nice staining here, the ridges, and here's the back. And I use this beautiful faux leather ribbon and beads for the closure, the journal inside. Let's open it up. So on the front there is this nice sturdy pocket, and for all the scraps and ephemera I made a little file folder. So this is the back, this is some laminating of leaves, autumn leaves from last year actually. And in the front is a little pocket with several tags. And on the first flap there is a side pocket with a little postcard and scraps of Tim Holtz paper and a little tag. And here is a glassine bag with several marble paper scraps, and there's also a little postcard here and a tag. Here's a little envelope with flower stickers or plant stickers, and now let's open it up so you can see it, and some vintage stamps I have in my stash. So these are the stems, and here for example the sticker. Okay, and in the back there is this big pocket for all the bigger ephemera, like this blank tag, this scrap tag, another glassine bag, some ledger, craft paper, and some vintage book page with this old German script form. So that's that. Now we come to the journal. It's the first time I made a fabric journal, and I used some upholstery fabric and lined it with Tim Holtz fabric, and it's tied in here with this faux leather ribbon. So just get it out. Yeah. First of all, find the middle. This would be very intelligent. Okay. As you can see, there are some mushrooms here, and here in the front pocket there are some ephemera, and the journal pages, for the journal pages I did some digital printouts, there's some handmade paper, stamping, and some collages with fuzzy cutted mushrooms and backed with some paper of some kind. Always nice to do. And this is a leaf stamp, stenciling. Digit stamping. mushroom. Sorry for the bad quality of the video, but I have problems with my computer, so I have to do everything with my smartphone. And you don't have this full screen, so I just try to push the journal from left to right, that you can see the most important parts. And this is some stenciling here. Altogether, there are 80 pages, front and back, to write on, so not too bad. And in the back there is also a pocket with a vintage stamp and some ephemera, nice big journal card, fern tag and a little punched out tag. So this is the journal. And here you see the art box with some Tim Holtz paper on it, which fit the color scheme, I think. So there's just a little twine for the closure around this bead. And inside of the lid there's also some Tim Holtz paper. And here are some more goodies. A little pair of scissors, a faux leather ribbon, some twine, washi tape and a paper flower in it. And there are three kinds of fabric scraps. Here's the little Uhu stick, some lace, and a little bay with some hardware, buttons, clips, book plate, and bulb pins for charms, and some charms too, and binder's clip. You can put the binder's clip onto the lid and so that you can work on your paper. So clip the paper on it and then you can work on it. And here are some colored pencils. A black archival pen from Faber-Castell and a pencil from Faber-Castell with eraser. Yeah. So there's some more room for your own stuff. I don't know what you want to take with you. So the box is self-made, painted, I cut everything all glued it together. Yeah. This almost always the challenging part. Work with wood. But it makes a lot of fun. Okay, guys. This is my third try to make a video. I hope this will work out. Okay, thank you very much for watching, and I say bye till next time. Tschüss, bis zum nächsten Mal.